Good morning. There are four things you need to remember about conductors in electrostatic equilibrium. Last time we went through the first three, today we are going to go through the last one.
Flipping physics.
The last of the four things you need to remember about conductors in electrostatic equilibrium is that for an irregular shape, the local surface charge density is at its maximum where the radius of curvature is at its minimum. In other words, the largest number of excess charges per area will be where the radius of curvature is the smallest. To prove this, we have two conducting spheres connected by a long conducting wire with the whole system in electrostatic equilibrium. This system is a conductor in electrostatic equilibrium. In other words, when two conductors are brought into contact with one another, the charges redistribute such that both conductors are at the same electric potential. Please realize this happens so quickly that the time for this to occur is considered to be negligible.
All right. Both conductors have the same electric potential because all the charges are on the surfaces of the conductors in electrostatic equilibrium, and the surfaces of conductors in electrostatic equilibrium are equipotential surfaces. So when two charged conductors touch one another, the excess charges redistribute themselves to make it so both conductors are at the same electric potential.
Exactly, Billy. For our example, the radius of sphere 2 is smaller than the radius of sphere 1, and the distance d between the two spheres is much, much larger than either radius. Because this is a conductor in electrostatic equilibrium, the electric potential on the surface of each sphere has the same value of the Coulomb constant times charge all over the radius of each sphere.
Everybody brought the Coulomb constant to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
Sure. We can then rearrange the equation to get the charge on sphere 1 equals the ratio of the radii of the two spheres, 1 over 2, times the charge on sphere 2. Because radius 2 is less than radius 1, radius 1 divided by radius 2 is greater than 1. That means the excess charge on sphere 1 is greater than the excess charge on sphere 2. The magnitude of the electric field at the surface of each sphere equals the Coulomb constant times charge divided by the square of the radius of the sphere. We can use those equations to get the ratio of the electric fields at the surface of each sphere, 1 over 2. We can simplify that equation by multiplying by the multiplicative inverse of the denominator. The Coulomb constant cancels out on the top and bottom. For charge 1, we can substitute in radius 1 over radius 2 times charge 2. And now a lot of variables cancel out. Charge 2 cancels out. One of the radii for sphere 2 cancels out. And one of the radii for sphere 1 cancels out. And all we are left with is radius 2 over radius 1. That means electric field 2 equals radius 1 over radius 2 times electric field 1. And again, because radius 2 is smaller than radius 1, radius 1 over radius 2 is greater than 1. That means the electric field at the surface of sphere 2 is more than the electric field at the surface of sphere 1. And because we previously showed that the electric field at the surface of a conductor in electrostatic equilibrium equals the local surface charge density over permittivity of free space, that means the surface charge density of sphere 2 is more than the surface charge density of sphere 1. We have just shown that where the radius of curvature of a conductor in electrostatic equilibrium is smaller, there is a larger surface charge density. In other words, where the local surface charge density is at a maximum, the radius of curvature of the conductor in electrostatic equilibrium is at a minimum. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.